The opinions expressed in this program reflect only those of the participants and are not necessarily those of the sponsors, management, or staff of WTBQ Radio or FST Broadcasting Corporation.
WTBQ. Good morning. You're listening to the Nonprofit Notebook. My name is Anquinette Hayles, Advancement Consultant for Greystone Programs. And every show, I'm excited for the special guests that we tend to have in rotation. And this month, I have the pleasure of interviewing Mark Chisholm. He and his family own the Wine Time store in Warwick, New York. And so, Mark, welcome to the Nonprofit Notebook. Is this your first time?
It's been a while since I've been on. It's been a while. So, yeah. Yeah. Love the community here at WTBQ and Warwick, but it's been a while since I've been on air, so thank you for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for being on the show. I know since I've been doing the radio, you haven't been on, so I was like, we got to get you on the show.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, yeah. And so you've definitely been doing great work in the community, so we're going to talk a little bit about that, and I'd love for you to introduce yourself just to the listeners who, you know, hadn't had the pleasure of listening to you when you were on the air. So,
all right. My name is Mark Chisholm. I'm a Warwick resident since 1979. My family moved here when I was a pup. I was just little 8 years old, and it was a game changer for me coming out of, you know, lower Westchester County, Mount Vernon, to beautiful Warwick, New York, farm and country and cows and trees. It was just eye-opener, game changer for an eight-year-old, if you can imagine that.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, you go through life. I graduated Warwick High School in 1989, class of 89. I'm a Pace University graduate in 1994.
Nice.
And I went to Pace in Westchester County there in Briarcliff and Pleasantville. And as soon as I graduated, I got a job right in the alcohol industry.
Wow.
I went right to work for a company called Ublin. And my first job was a merchandiser. And my job was to merchandise Smirnoff, Jose Cuervo, Finlandia Vodka, and Lancer's Wine.
Oh, my God.
I don't know how much of that is still around, but I know the Smirnoff is still around. I'm very impartial to Smirnoff Vodka because they gave me my first job.
Yes,
you know?
Yes.
So it's brand loyalty there. So, yes. And then from there, you know, I worked in I've been in the alcohol industry since, you know, 1994. I mean, I'm 30 years now in the industry, which is absolutely incredible.
30 years. That is incredible.
And then so I've been, you know, selling wine and liquor forever for distributors and retailers and wineries and an import company. I currently work for the Chateau Diana, a very nice family owned winery out of Healdsburg, California. It's owned by a brother and sister team. You got, the Corey and Dawn Manning, two of the nicest people you ever meet. Corey takes care of the winery. Dawn takes care of the sales, and they're my bosses, and they're the nicest people. I mean, really, really, the three of us, we're a good team. Yeah. And then we've got a girl out in Long Island who does a good job for us as well. Her name is Leslie. So it's a small company, but you know, we move the needle.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. And small beginnings. I mean, I feel like that's the echo of the Hudson Valley, right?
Yeah,
it's made up of so many small beginnings, family-owned businesses who ultimately grow and become staples in the community. So that's wonderful.
And then in about 2015-16, my dad passed away, and he left me some money. And I went to a financial advisor, and he's like, you know, Mark, we could take this money, we could grow, you know, $20,000 over 3 years. And I was like, that's not enough. So I took that money, invested, and that's when we opened up Wine Time Wines and Liquors out of Route 94 in the Flowick Plaza.
Mm-hmm.
So we're right between, you know, the hospital in Warwick and, you know, in the town of Florida. We're up there in that little Flowick Plaza. People drive by us every day. They don't even know we're there. But when they stop in, we got you because we're a great shop. We're very geek. We're good drinkers.
Yes.
I'll put it to you that way. So, and then that takes me to here today. So, you know, it's nice to be here.
Wow. That is an amazing journey. And I'm always curious about how people got their start. So did you, in college, you just kind of said, you know, this is an industry.
Well, I mean, I think everyone drinks a little bit in college. You know, that's your first experience, you know, other than when you're stealing, you know, beers from your dad's fridge, you know, stuff like that when you're younger. So that's part of it. But I graduated from marketing degree, marketing, management, sales. And I had three companies pick up my resume. One company was a company called Kodak, which maybe you heard of them,
I
went all the way to Rochester to realize real quick, I don't want to sell photocopiers for a living.
Ah.
So that's what he said it was. Then I had a carpet company called Normandy Lifton that wanted to hire me. They offered me like $20,000. And I looked at him, I go, Are you? I can make more money than that working at Walmart, is what I said to them. So, of course, I didn't take that. And then I got the position for Ubline. I was working for Peerless Imports. They've been dissolved, I think, to now Empire Distributors. And it was a great job. I mean, it was a great salary. It was a company car. Every year was a $3,000 bonus.
Oh,
you're selling alcohol. I was like the coolest guy, you know?
You are the coolest
You couldn't
guy.
Have a better roommate than Mark Chisholm because of all the samples I got to take home. So, yeah, that's for sure.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Wow. I love it. I love to hear the backstory about how everyone came to be and to just think that you were just looking for a little investment and then here we are. You have a family-owned liquor store, and
it's a great shop. It's really cute. I mean, we really specialize. We carry your national brands, uh-huh. but then we're all about the small up-and-coming producer. That's where the best bang for your buck is.
Mm-hmm.
The small up-and-coming producer before the wine spectator, before wine enthusiasts, you know, picks up on them, they go up in price, and that's what we specialize in.
Oh, okay.
Again, we're good drinkers, so we sample everything, uh-huh. so we can help you, guide you, you know, because it's all about that wine experience. Mm-hmm. I mean, for us, when we buy wine, I buy wine that inspires you. And there's a difference when you take a sip from a glass of wine and you go, wow, you stop and you think about it. You go, damn, that is good. And inspires you to go back to the glass and have another sip. And that's really what it's all about, the Wine Time Wines and Liquors. We're all about that inspiration, you know, that the cocktail, the wine. We believe in drinking better, but drinking less,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. And you brought some with
yeah,
you.
Yeah, real
to
quick
talk
before
about.
We talk about the Greystones, I did bring some product that I want to talk about. Let me pull out this first product right here. So these are some products that we absolutely love at Wine Time Wines and Liquors. This first mm-hmm. product is a French sparkling wine called Les Azes.
Mm-hmm.
It's sparkling brut, so it's got a little pinkish hue to it. So it's got some Pinot Noir and Chardonnay in it.
Okay.
Pinot Noir is a red grape, so
yep.
it's got some Pinot Noir and Chardonnay in it.
Mm-hmm.
The wine is soft, it's supple, it's creamy, it's got good acidity on the finish. Very crushable for $12.50 a bottle.
Okay.
Very crushable.
$12 a bottle. Okay. So now tell me, because this is always the hard part. What do you pair it with? Because people, you know, they get a good bottle, but then they're like, I don't know what to do with it.
I think a sparkling wine, you could just chill it and kill it, sit on the porch, watch the traffic go by.
Okay.
If you're going to have some food with this wine in particular, this Laissez sparkling brut, I would do like some shellfish with it. Shrimp, oyster, lobster, crab would pair very nicely with it.
Okay.
Because the acidity will help rinse away that sea. You know, that's on the mussels and the clams and all that. So
okay.
Beautiful, beautiful bottle of wine. Great effervescence, beautiful bottle of sparkling wine.
Okay, that's Mark's recommendation.
I also brought a bottle called Tokowika.
Ooh.
So this is a Sauvignon Blanc from New Zealand. It's from the Marlborough region, New Zealand.
Okay.
It's a bone dry, crisp, clean, refreshing white wine of high acidity, a lot of grapefruit, a lot of lemon peel to it. It is absolutely awesome. And again, this is a nice wine to pair with pasta of a cream sauce, grilled chicken and rice, your shellfish again, because of the high acidity, it's very cleansing on the palate.
Okay.
Rockstar wine for $15.99. I mean, we sell Oyster Bay side by side. This product is much nicer than the Oyster Bay. Better bang for your buck for the same price.
Wow.
So we love that.
Okay.
All right. The next one I have a white wine called the Lily.
And it's a pretty bottle.
Yeah, this is real fun and funky. You notice it's kind of purple in the bottle. So this is Lily. It's a blended California white wine infused with the butterfly pea flower. What the heck is the butterfly pea flower?
Is that what gives it its color?
Yeah, so the butterfly pea flower is an all-natural herb ingredient, and it has a lot of health benefits to it. It helps lower blood pressure. It's good for digestion. It's good for healthy hair, teeth, and nails. So there's a lot of benefits in this. So it's a healthy wine. Plus, it's lower in alcohol. It's only 6% alcohol. So you can have a couple of glasses, still keep your cognitive about you, get yourself home safe, and pay your bills online when you get home.
Interesting.
But it's a fun, fruity wine. Chill it and enjoy it. It's got a hint of sweetness to it. And good food pairing for this would just be anything. I think you could have barbecue with it. I think you could have pizza with it. Honestly, there's no rules just right. But it's a fun little wine. And again, when you pour a glass, it's purple in the cup. And it's like nothing you've ever seen before. So
wow.
It's absolutely awesome.
Okay.
The next wine I brought is an Italian red wine called Primitivo. So this is the Anna Adone Vineyards Primitivo.
Okay.
Primitivo is Italian red Zinfandel. So this wine is super high in alcohol. It's really smooth. It's silky. It's got a long peppery finish to it. Killer red wine. Again, grilled meats and vegetables, pastas of a red sauce, barbecue go really, really nice with that.
Okay.
And then last but not least, because I see we're almost up to the break. Last but not least, I have a Can with me, because canned cocktails are just on fire right now.
Are they?
Oh, man, everybody wants canned cocktails. The convenience, you crack it, you drink it, it's already mixed, the alcohol's in it, it's consistent time in, time out. I mean, there's a lot of canned products out there. This is one of my favorites. I think this is actually one of the best cans on the market. Okay. It's called the Original Long Drink. It comes from Finland. So mm-hmm. when Finland had the World's Fair back in like the 50s, they didn't have a national drink, and this is the drink they came up with. And it is beautifully balanced with gin, grapefruit, and lime. And it's absolutely terrific. So smooth, so clean, absolutely terrific. I'm sorry, grapefruit. Gin, grapefruit, and seltzer. Absolutely terrific product. I mean, I would crack it open with you right now, but you got to go all the way back to Poughkeepsie, and it's only 11:16 in the morning. Not that that would stop me from drinking. I'm just saying, I'm keeping an eye on you. But again, these are all products that we love. They're all really nicely priced. I mean, you have $15.99 for the Sauv Blanc. The Lily is $11.99. The Primitivo is $59. And the Original Long Drink is only $2.99 a can for 5.5% alcohol. It's really solid. Terrific, terrific product. I'm going to send you home with a bottle or something, all right? When I see you at the trade show, you can let me know, all right?
Okay,
for the fundraiser.
Absolutely, absolutely. So we're going to go to a quick commercial break. You're listening to the Nonprofit Notebook. We'll be right back.
Greystone Programs is a nonprofit human services agency that provides essential services to more than 600 children, adults, and families living with autism and other developmental disabilities. Greystone Programs also provides residential support in a community environment with 17 homes in the Mid-Hudson Valley area. Greystone Programs offers exceptional care and support for a variety of programs and services. To get involved or for more information, visit greystoneprograms.org.
Hey, I'm TJ.
What's up? I'm Jaybo.
Join us on the next TJ show. The goal is that we find the encouraging, uplifting stories that are still happening on this planet. It's hard to find them.
But they're happening.
They're happening all over the place. We just got to look for them. It's coming up on the next TJ show. We can't wait to see you there.
WTBQ.
And we're back. You're listening to the Nonprofit Notebook if you're just tuning in. And with us today, we have Mark Chisholm. His family owns the Wine Time liquor store in Warwick, New York. It's a nice small boutique business that is doing a great work in the community. And so your connection with Greystone Programs, let's talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's a great thing. So I think this happened back in like, you know, like 2012, maybe 2013. Maggie Gephardt, who was the manager of Liquorama up there in Hyde Park, uh-huh. you know, I've been selling wine to her forever. Unbelievable woman. I hope she's listening. I don't know if she is. But she said to me, "Hey, Mark, we're doing a fundraiser. I need an auctioneer. You're my guy." I go, "What? I don't know." But I went, and Rich Swanson was there, who's like the nicest guy from Greystone. I mean, he gets me to come back year after year. He really does. And he made me very calm and very smooth. And the second I had the microphone, the light switched, and I just became an auctioneer. And it's just just about having fun, you know?
What a great story. So I didn't even know that.
Yeah, that's how it started.
So my first experience with an auction was watching you last year, mm-hmm. and you did an amazing job. Like, it was so... I guess it was like breathtaking, because watching it, you're animated and everyone really had a good time. You had folks laughing and standing up. So it was great.
Yeah,
it's so good to have you back.
It only takes two or three people to jack up the price or something. if two people both want, it's easy to get it up there in price. And I mean, the items that you had last year for auction were absolutely unbelievable. I mean, we had the Sazerac Rye, we had the Thomas Hardy bourbons. Mm-hmm. I mean, yes. We had the Eagle Rare 17-year-old, which was what we finished with. And I think that fetched like $2,200, rightfully so. I mean, it's one of the rarest bourbons you'll ever see in this country. So it's a terrific product. But just the lot of wines, and it was really nice. And what was the name of the winery again? Milea?
Milea. Yes, and we're
winery.
Back there this year.
What a beautiful venue. Folks, if you haven't been over to Milea Vineyards, you really need to go check it out.
I mean,
It's so calm and picturesque and beautiful, and their wines are good, and their food is good. And it's a great picture opportunity for your Facebook, your Instagram, to be
honest
with you.
Very good photo ops.
Yeah.
It sits on this nice little hill, like not too high, not too low, overlooks the vineyard. It's a great, great venue. And the owners are phenomenal. They're wonderful. They have a really good team over there at Milea. And we're so happy to be back with them this year. And so if you don't know and you're listening, we are having our 32nd annual wine tasting and auctions on September the 29th, 2024 at 1 p.m. at the Milea Estate Vineyard. So be sure to head over to greystoneprograms.org and check it out. Grab a ticket. And we hope to see you at the vineyard.
Just let me describe to the listeners who are listening. You go there and you're treated like royalty. It's food passed around, walked around. It is vendors sitting there from the distributors tasting wine, tasting beer, tasting ciders, tasting spirits.
Yes.
And it's all included with the price of the ticket.
It is.
There is a silent auction, which is pretty amazing. The items they have up for silent auction.
Yeah, we had a lot of vacations and a lot of spa packages and baskets and so on. Yeah.
And there's always the director always speaks and he thanks everyone coming and he reminds us why we're there. And it's a great reason why we're there. I mean, my nephew is autistic. He's very highly functioning autistic. So it kind of hits home, especially now that he's 19. Because, you know, you guys are all about helping the adults.
Absolutely.
And it hits home for me. So that's why I do it each and every year. I look forward to it, to be honest with you. So
yes.
I really do. And I encourage folks to come enjoy it. Make a date day of it, to be honest with you. Get a sitter, come out, take a limo. Come out, have a good time, get your buzz on, get a hotel room, and be in love again. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I'm just saying,
get an Uber,
really
make it a girls' night or girls' day out.
Yeah.
It's a great event. We're going to have live music. And Milea did some renovations, so I can't wait for you to see what they've done to the space. It's absolutely beautiful. So a lot more outdoors that we're able to do this year. So we're really looking forward to that. And they're also providing the catering this year.
Oh, nice.
I've been up there for a few of their events, and their chef is wonderful, Chef Kim. So I'm looking forward to a lot of the tasty, delectable bites that are going to be offered. Yeah. But yeah, it is a good time.
Yeah. And if you've never been to a live auction, I mean, there's some like 30, 31 lots to auction off. It takes some time. I mean, we got to take a break, let Rich talk a little bit, let Rich tell some of the jokes for a minute, you know what I'm saying? So I can catch my breath, get some water.
Absolutely.
And then we come back for the second half. But it is a hoot. It's a great time. And it's an awesome group of people that go to it. Again, I don't know. This might be my 8th or 9th year doing it, to be honest with you. So I really enjoy it. And again, it's nice to give back.
It is nice to give back.
It's important to give back to.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, if you're just listening for the first time, Greystone Programs is doing a great work in the Hudson Valley. It serves over 650 adults, families, and children with autism and intellectual developmental disabilities. And just providing that service. And what most people don't know is outside of what's provided by the state, there is that need for sponsorships and donations, because there is other aspects of life that don't get covered that we want to make sure that is provided. So, for example, whenever an individual comes into one of the homes are customized to that individual, the rooms, the paint colors, just all of the details, really to make it a home and not make it feel like an institution. And I love when I'm posting online about the homes and sharing photos for Greystone, I love saying it's a family. It truly is. In each of the homes, it's a family, but it's also a family overall with the organization that they're doing. So
I can feel that when I'm in the room and everyone's there. You can definitely feel that it is family and you guys really care. And,
absolutely.
And that's the most touching part is that you really genuinely care and do everything you can to help people. And that's amazing. That is amazing. Everybody should take a minute every day to help somebody.
I think so too.
Yeah.
That's
be a good person, right? It comes back to you. Yeah.
I love like the little back to school stuff. You see a lot of the shirts or the book bags that just says be kind for the children, because you know, sometimes we get caught up and we forget, you know, but our true nature should just be to love on each other and to really appreciate what we have.
Agreed.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because COVID, we were talking earlier before the show started about just everything that was going on pre-COVID and, you know, coming out of it. It was an eye opener, right?
I think people are still coming out of it, to be honest with
you. That's a good point.
Businesses haven't fully recovered yet. New York City hasn't fully recovered yet. So I think people are still coming out of it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, listen, thank goodness it's behind us. Hope we don't have to see that again. Because, you know, although I had a great masks, I had a good collection of masks. I really did, you know.
Did you now?
But I'd rather just show my teeth, to be honest
right.
with you.
Yeah, I was over wearing the mask, but definitely I'll put a mask on if I feel like yeah. I still have one in my back pocket just in case.
Always.
So, yeah. Okay. So September 29th, you'll be with us. You'll be the auctioneer. So if you're listening, you want to come check Mark out. Do we want to get them a little sample of what you do?
Oh, my
as an
goodness.
Auctioneer?
All right. Let's auction off the wine. All right.
Let's do it.
All right. Here we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, next wine up, we've got the Laissez Sparkling Brut Rosé. I'm going to start the bidding at $100. It's going to be $100. I got $100. It's going to be $125. I got $125. $125 is going to give me $150. I got $150 over here. So I'm looking for $175. I got $175 over here looking for $200. I'm looking for $200, $200, $200, $200. $175 is bail. I'm looking for $200. I got $200 over here looking for $225, $225. $225 in the back of the room. New bidder, welcome. I got $225 looking for $250. It's going to give me $250, $250, $250 over here. I'm looking for $275, $275 for charity. $275 for charity. I got $275, $275, $250. $250 going once, $250 going twice. Sold. $250.
That was so good, Mark. Thank you so much. So if you're listening, you want to come check Mark out at the 32nd Annual Wine Tasting and Auctions with Greystone Programs on September 29, 2024 at 1 p.m. We're going to be at the Milea Estate Vineyard. You have been wonderful, Mark. I just really enjoyed
the show.
This
is a lot of fun. It's
you
a
are a lot of fun.
Yeah, that's great.
And be sure to check Mark out on social media, Wine Time Warwick, on Instagram. They're on Facebook. Check their website out or just drive over and stop in. If anything that he said today piqued your interest, I'm sure there's lots, lots more when you're actually in the store. So thank you again, Mark. Is there anything else that you want to just leave?
I mean, it's a blessing. I love to give back. I love the event. I really do. I mean, who would have thought I would be an auctioneer? You know,
and you're
I mean,
really it's good just, at it.
I enjoy it. You know, you pop a 5-hour energy and you're good to go for an auction.
You don't need the 5-hour energy.
No, you're right. but for people listening in the Warwick area and outside in Goshen and in Vernon, where we are, if you haven't been to the liquor store, Wine Time Wines and Liquors, Route 94 North in Warwick, come check us out.
Yes.
I'm telling you, we're small. We're intimate, we're good drinkers. We only recommend stuff that inspires us. And it's not always more money. It's a lateral move.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, folks, you don't need to drink any more Josh Cabernet. You can get better wine for less money,
mm-hmm.
for sure. And it's a better wine experience. Now, listen, we have the Josh. You can always come back to it. But it's when you try items side by side by side, that's when you can really pick up the subtle differences.
Absolutely.
It's the same thing with the vodka. Listen, we crush it with Tito's all day out there for $32.99 for the Tito's Mags. I mean, it's the best price around.
Mm-hmm.
But there's so much other vodka out there that I think is, again, I think Smirnoff is a better vodka for $24.99 for the Mag. But,
oh, wow.
You know, I'm very impartial. They gave me my first job. So we invite people to come down, check at the shop. Again, we carry your national favorites. But we have new brands.
Nice.
So I guess what you could say is find what you love, love what you find at Wine Time Wines and Liquors.
Oh, I love that. We're going to end here. This has been really, really great. Oh, I just can't stop smiling, Mark. You have been wonderful. Thank you so much for coming on the show today. As always, you're listening to The Nonprofit Notebook. Be sure to check Greystone Programs out at www.greystoneprograms.org. That's our time. Have a wonderful, beautiful day.
Thank you.